Hey, what's up, fly girls, fly guys? I'm here in San Salvador, Bahamas, and I picked up this inflatable stand-up paddleboard, and it was probably only, well, it was less than $300, and I figured it'd be great. Got a DIY fly fishing trip while on the Viking, while I got a day off or so, I can go get some bonefish on fly and be kind of independent of needing a boat or and still being able to travel pretty far, probably wade once I get there. So this looked like an ideal situation. I met Max here locally playing pool, and he's going fishing. He agreed to take me, give me a ride across the island to a place called Pigeon Creek. I saw it on Google Maps and Google Earth, and it looks like a really neat place. Lots of mangroves and flats. It looks ideal for a bonefish if we're going to find one anywhere on the island. It's a 40-minute ride over there. So what we're going to do is we're going to get this inflated and throw it in the back of his truck, I think, first. And that's what we'll do. Now, I'm using a 6-weight TFO with a floating bonefish taper line. Probably going to go with about a 12-foot leader. I've got a handful of gotchas that I've been using, or that I bought over at the store. They're just store-bought. I have a feeling we should be doing pretty good on this this day. It's been a little overcast yesterday, and today it looks like it's a little front moving through. But yeah, stay tuned. Let's get at it.
Dropping a pause and a couple strips. There he is. Super cool. Standing right here, just blind casting because the wind, I can't see much. Comes the fly line back on. First Bahamian bone, we get it back. Surprising, I was just about to change flies. I thought, oh, this orange fly isn't doing anything. He's here. Third run. Not bad. Solo on fly, no doubt. Thank you. What a beauty. Next spot now. If the wind's picking up, obviously it looks like a rainstorm is coming. Might get a little wet. Still haven't seen any bones here as I'm paddling, but looking out far in the distance, but a little hull slap on this thing. Feel good now, I got my first bone under the for the day with the belt. Incredible run. Nice! There was a whole bunch of them in there. And I thought it would spook them, but apparently not. Great run. This is flat. It's full of potholes. Like up and down a couple feet. I'm up to my ankle, then I'm up to my knee. Get around this mangrove. It's coming towards us. Now I'm up again, a couple feet. Wow, what a backdrop. Look at this place to catch a bonefish. Totally do it yourself, DIY fly. In the mid-Bahamas on a paddleboard from Walmart. Beautiful backdrop here with the traditional what you would think you would find. You know, a bonefish with the mangroves like this, creeping around. Fantastic. The TFO power doing work. Figuring out what to do with this thing.
that one might just be the PB right there for right now. And here in the Bahamas, that's a nice one. That's a nice one.
Man, it's shaking like crazy. Guy's not done yet. Surely he must be done. You guys are really, really exceptional fighters after you get inside. Super low tide, and done bone fishing now. Went 2 for 3, so it's pretty good. And start heading back. So this is the fly I was using, just a tiny little gotcha, and nothing fancy. Let's see, I'll show you. Here it is. There's a fly. Little gotcha, little orange, little chenille. All right, guys, that's it. That's a wrap. Booyah! Next time, maybe tomorrow.
We've visited some fascinating places. Click one of the video links on the screen now to see us exploring and fishing some really unique locations.